Catch me at a function, only baddies at this function. Look, step on my feet, bitch, we gon' jump. You spent like 10 at Webster, D.O. what I step in. My bag Louis V, Glocks and beams, all up in his feet. Run up, you gon' see, heard of me. Pussy, why you flexing? Know you heard of me. Like me, then we fucking, don't start stalking me. Point to where the money getters is. Bring your friends, tell them this where all the money getters is. Tell them niggas, wait, you don't wanna run up on that kid. Better tell them niggas, last one try to do it, he got dead.
What's good with y'all, Brian? For another video, and as you can read by the title, I'm finna give y'all the best playmaking badges. So if you need help with your playmaking badges, whether you're a big, a guard, a lock, a forward, don't matter. This video is for you, but always, you know I gotta do it, bro. Before I hop into the video, if you do enjoy the content, make sure you drop a like and subscribe. Share this video with your cousin, bro. You know they need the playmaking badges too. They be in the park, they be in the stage. Share this cousin. Share this with your cousins, your aunties, your uncles. Share the video. Without further ado, bro, I'm not going to hold y'all up too much, so we finna hop straight into the video. So first things first, you want to pick out what position you play. So this is mainly for the guards. So we're going to go with guards first. So we're going to go down the list and break down all the playmaking badges. So these are the playmaking badges I use. I use ankle breaker on Hall of Fame, gold Neo Threader, gold bailout, Hall of Fame quick first step, gold unpluckable, gold killer combos, and gold handles for days. Now some of y'all are wondering, Dre, why don't you use clamp breaker? Why don't you use hyperdrive? Now here's my opinion, this is my personal opinion. Clamp breaker is very good, don't get me wrong. It's a good badge to have on, especially if you're around the bigger heights, like 6'3 and above, and you're like a slasher, like someone who can really attack the rim, then I would put on clamp breaker. But me, I'll probably show you some clips in the middle, and like not the middle of the video, but like towards the beginning of the video. I'm more of a 300. I shoot a lot of threes. That's what I'm known for. I'm known for being a really big three shooter. So I shoot a lot of threes. So clamp breaker doesn't really do much for me. And the way I play, I need needle threader. So like I run wide over the screen. I like to throw dots. So like I like passing the ball and like tight windows. So needle threader gold is very much needed. Sometimes like once you throw it, it won't let them press square. It'll stun them. And then a lot of the times when they press square, it'll fly like kind of like a little bit over their hands to the plate when it pops up. So needle threader is very good. Now bailout is very good if you like attacking wings and fading a lot. If you like to fade a lot, I will put on bailout. This badge makes it so like if you pass out of your shot, the person catching the ball doesn't fumble it. And the way gold bailout is set up is if I'm attacking wing and I bail out off of fade on the right side of the court, the pass will be so perfect. It'll never give you like a load up. It'll never give you anything bad because I have it on gold. So it'll give you a perfect catch off of fade. And that's like my go-to, bro. I like to attack the wings, and that's what I have gold bailout on. Now hyperdrive does work. It does work. A lot of people says it doesn't work. It does work. The most of the time when it pops up is when you're like kind of driving upwards, like up the court and like towards the basket. That's when it mainly pops up. But in my opinion, I don't really have enough badges for it. I do try to put it on sometimes to kind of play with it. So I'll do something like this. I'll take off needle and then put on hyperdrive. I'll do this sometimes, or I'll do this. That's how I normally do if I'm trying out clamp breaker. But most of the time, this is what I'm rocking. Hall of Fame ankle breaker does work. If you want me to show you how to activate ankle breaker animations, it's so overpowered. Trust me. If you want a video, I'm telling you, I can really drop a video on these ankle breakers. This badge works really, really good, especially when you have badge. Bro, I'm telling you. If I showed you clips of when I have this Hall of Fame ankle breaker and when I have playmaker badge and the stuns and animations I get, it's crazy. I'm trying to tell you, bro. But this, I'm giving y'all too much sauce now. But if y'all want the video on that, let me know. But unpluckable. Now, I know a lot of point guards who don't run unpluckable because like the plucks are so OP. But I don't know if you guys seen it. I believe LD2K made a tweet and said that he sent the pluck stuff to Mike and he's gonna like try to tweak it and stuff. So I'm pretty sure that plucks are gonna be patched soon. So this is a hot take. I believe that when they patch the plugs, you're not, it's gonna be like the complete opposite. You know how now you get a bunch of steals? I feel like after they patch the plugs, you're not gonna be able to get none. So you never know, bro. But some people don't run it. I run it because I don't want to grade out and I like to hold on to the ball. So I just keep it on. Hall of Fame, quick first up, self-explanatory. If you are moving slow or you're trying to dribble and you're not getting certain animations, you don't have this badge on, this is the reason why. You have to have Hall of Fame quick first step if you're a guard. Some builders you can get away with having like a silver or gold, but if you're a point guard and you run the offense most of the time, I think you should have Hall of Fame quick first step. Handles for days, self-explanatory. Some people don't use it because they said it's useless because of the Gatorade stuff, but I use it. I like to save stamina. I like to dribble a lot. I can dribble pretty good this year, I would say, but yeah, this helps me. So like, if you don't know, like when you lose stamina, your shot gets slower. So having handles for days is good. So like sometimes like my shot won't slow down because I have more stamina because I have it on goal. So I really want to know how Hall of Fame handles for days is. That would probably be crazy, right? Yeah, that would probably be crazy. Killer combos goal. Honestly, this is probably the best playmaking badge. If you don't have this badge on, then put this shit on right now. I'm immediately close the video, load your player up, get this badge. And one more thing before I tell you to get this badge, make sure that you have your core badges. You need your core badges. You see I have three so far. I can't really get my build has no defense. Like my build, this is my build. If you want to show, if you want to see the more of the build, go watch the build video a couple videos ago if you didn't watch it. But you see, I got no defense, so I don't really care about calling a defensive badge. I'm kind of halfway through off-ball pest, but it doesn't really matter. Like, it doesn't really. I'll probably put on silver off-ball pest in my core, bro. But, all right, you probably can, but. Oh, you can't. You can probably core gold. Okay, well, whenever I core it, I'll put it on, bro. But these badges don't really mean anything. Okay, yeah. These don't really mean nothing, the defensive badges, but make sure. You core like any other badges, like finishing, shooting, playmaking. If you want a video on how to core badges super fast, let me know in the comment section below, because I did core. Let me go to my shooting. I did also core. I have blinders core. I also have Deadeye core too. So I have Deadeye and blinders core. My Asian 3 is about halfway to being core too. So. But yeah, I put on blinders. But I have blinders and Deadeye cord. And I have quick first step cord. I have special delivery cord on gold. This is from my career, though. This is from my career, grinding my player. Hall of Fame, yeah. And then killer combo, this should be halfway, yep. Clamp breaker, I barely use clamp breaker. Bailout should be kind of high, too. No, never mind. But hyperdrive, it's pretty close. But yeah, make sure you core your badges. If you're not coring your badges, you're putting yourself at a big disadvantage, and they really don't take that long to get. They might take that long to get online, but if you do the My Career glitch, you can really get a badge core in a few games. I got Deadeye core really, really, really fast. Like, probably like under a couple, honestly, under five games, I got Deadeye core. So if you want the video on how to get any badge core, how to get your badges super fast, let me know. I'll drop a video on that too. But other than that, also what you want to do is you want to make sure that your passing style, you have a good passing style. So some people have Curry on. Curry is bad. The best passing style is LeBron James. Let me see other ones. Magic is bad. LaMelo is decent, I heard, but it's not really that good. LeBron is the fastest, though. Everybody uses LeBron. If you're a competitive player, you know to use LeBron. But that's pretty much it. If you guys have any video suggestions, make sure you leave in the comment section below. I always try to do videos for y'all. But that's pretty much it. If you guys need help with anything, you can hit me up on Twitter at HoodieDre_, or you can hit me up at on Instagram, CashDre_. It's a K in the cash, bro. But that's pretty much it for the video. If you did enjoy the video, make sure you like, comment, subscribe if you're new. I'm trying to think, is there anything else? Takeovers. Most of the time, I won't use this. I'll use this instead. Playmaking badge is good as fuck this year. Really, 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 really good. Like, you can hit whites type shit, but nobody really knows that. They didn't watch the tits video. But I gotta say, without further ado, man, these are my badges. I go over one more time. Here's the playmaking badges. Here are the badges I use. These are the best playmaking badges, in my opinion. Especially if you're a small point guard or you play prime competitively, these are the badges you should use. I move fine. You seen at the beginning of the video, the clips. I move crazy. I shoot from half court. I'm pretty damn good at the game so far. So I'm gonna keep playing the game. I'm gonna keep getting this content out for y'all. But like I said, if you guys have any video suggestions, leave them in the comment section below. I'm finna close this video off. So like I said, without further ado, if you did enjoy the video, make sure you like, comment, subscribe if you're new. And I'm out, bro.